O great creator, the true master, the swiftest of reckoners, you are the mighty one of Jacob who will deliver the tribes of Native America, saving us out of all places where we have been scattered in the cloudy and dark day, saving us from calamity, for you are our stay. Thus saith the Lord God, I will make my children of Native America, and the places round about my hill of blessing, and I will cause the shower to come down in his season, there shall be showers of blessing, and the tree of the field shall yield her fruit, and the earth shall yield her increase, and they shall be safe in their land, and shall know that I am the Lord, when I have broken the bands of their yoke, and delivered them out of the hand of those that serve themselves of them, and they shall no more be a prey to the heathen, neither shall the beast of the land devour them, but they shall dwell safely, and none shall make them afraid. Thus shall they know that I the Lord their God am with them. We, the tribes of Native America, call upon the Creator, who delivers us from the darkness of land and sea, for we call upon him humbly and inwardly, in gratitude, thankfully. Amen.
This is April Shaltai's. Native America is a covenant land, given by the Lord to his covenant people for a perpetual possession. The forgotten genocide of Native Americans on the American continent was not forgotten by God, was not forgotten by God. This is the end of the thousand years tribulation. Psychic predators are using hypnosis and psychic attack against you. They use the unseen realm, also called the astral plane, the realm of thought, against you, and they call it science of the mind. They are humans, but they will impersonate God, guardian angels, and numerous other identities that are supposed to advise and direct you. Don't let them get away with it. Refuse to listen to them, and stay in God's word. Practice psychic self-defense. Do not have sex. Do not eat meat, do not consume alcohol, read the Bible, respect all life, exorcise these invaders, the Bible calls them demons. The scriptures say, your God is one God, there is no God but He, the benevolent, the compassionate. This is April Shaltai's. Native Americans suffered a genocide right here on their homelands. We need justice. We need to return all their lands, including their sacred mountains, like Tecate Peak in Southern California. It is Cuachama, an important place of worship to the Most High God. The Kumeyaay people's religious leaders want proper respect shown to their mountain, just as we would with Mount Sinai. We need to respect Native American religious beliefs. They are honoring God and the ancient ways of the Great Creator. Return their mountains. The scriptures say, Mount Sinai was altogether on a smoke, because the Lord descended upon it in fire, and the smoke thereof ascended as the smoke of a furnace, and the whole mount quaked greatly. And when the voice of the trumpet sounded long, and waxed louder and louder, Moses spake, and God answered him by a voice. This is April Shaltai's, using the computer to generate this message. This is Rome. Rome loves genocide. My brothers and niece are dead. Rome wants me dead, too. They decided to put me down. They don't need a reason, but I am an unmarried virgin past 50. I survived, but they don't want me to have any more birthdays. They poisoned my dogs. Then they used COVID as an excuse to take away everything. This is April Shaltai's, and I want to live, not die for any reason, for with long life the Lord will satisfy me. This is Rome, and Rome wants you to die in the arena. Rome is still here. Rome crucified Christ and created Christianity to cover up the genocide of Jews, Africans, Native Americans, and more. Mexicans are dying on the border every day. Never, never forget, never. The scriptures say, do not follow the footsteps of Satan. He is to you an open enemy. Thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast clapped thine hands, and stamped with the feet, and rejoiced in heart with all thy despite against the land of Israel, therefore I will destroy thee, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord. This is April Shaltai's. In the 1800s, the son of a local Shoshone chief was wrongly accused of stealing a horse and hanged. Even though everyone knew he was innocent, the boy was accused of stealing a horse near Summit Creek, now Smithfield Yador, but he was only fishing. Robert Thornley, a prominent resident of Summit Creek, knew the boy was innocent, and testified in his defense. But the Shoshone boy got no justice. The locals convicted him and hanged him, even though it was the Mering family that likely had the horse the entire time. The boy's name was recorded as Pugwini, but Pugwini is the Shoshone word for fish, so the boy may have been maintaining his innocence. They killed him anyway. Native Americans were frequently subjected to injustice, and could not even testify in court against whites. There's a forgotten genocide, right here in America. Millions of Native Americans were murdered, on their native lands. It was genocide. Never, never forget. We need justice. Return these lands to the Native American tribes, all of them. The scriptures say, "Behold, the heaven and the heaven of heavens is the Lord's thy God, the earth also, with all that therein is. The servants of God send the fertilizing winds, and send down water from the sky, and give it to you to drink, and you are not the ones who store it. It is we who give life and cause death, and we are the inheritors."